With Lois Duncan and Robert Schwartz, we go to your phone calls. Albuquerque, hello.
Hello, Larry. I'm calling from Albuquerque.
Yep.
And I wanted to ask this attorney, isn't this just another political ploy? It's an election year for him, and he's just trying to get on national television to help his campaign. He really doesn't care about this this case, or he wouldn't have dismissed the charges against the people.
What if he couldn't win it in court, though? If he doesn't dismiss, then you could never try him again.
Well, his office is known for dismissing cases, and he's known for pleading cases away. He never takes them to trial. How would he know? Because he doesn't take cases to trial.
Want to comment, Robert?
Well, again, I didn't come here to campaign, and I was invited by you, Larry,
to come on the show.
The
producers invited him. He didn't invite himself. So.
Again, it's a political contention. What I contend here, again, is the police put together as best a case they could. They are hunter-gatherers by nature, and they hunted and gathered what they could.
Are you satisfied with the job Mr. Schwartz has done?
I don't think Bob... Oh, as far as withdrawing the charges, absolutely, I think he had no choice.
Are you happy with the police work?
Not totally, no.
To New York City, hello.
Yes, hi. I feel for the young lady there. My condolences to you. But what makes this case any more important than many of the murders and the homicides and so forth that we have in New York and all over the United States?
You want me to answer?
All murders are important, Lois.
Yes, well, you're right. All murders are important. This case is important to us because it's our child, and everybody else, their beloved who is murdered, is the most important person in the world to them. And so, of course, I'm out trying to find my child's murderer because she was my daughter.
May I say something about
sure.
that, Larry? As a career prosecutor, let me point out something about this case. The caller is right. There are many aspects about this case that are unique, many that are typical for unsolved homicides where you don't have any physical evidence. What is important, I think, about this case is the fact that Lois was able to write a most gifted portrayal of the kind of pain that a victim goes through. And that's important and should be read by others.
In other words, victims should read this book.
Yes. You know. Or non-victims, so they know what a victim goes through.
Penshawken, New Jersey. Hello.
Yes, I'd like to ask Mr. Schwartz or Mrs. Duncan why they didn't consult Howard Stern.
Sorry, I have no idea what that is. To Albuquerque, New Mexico. Hello.
Hi. I'd like to ask Mr. Schwartz, if you believe this to be a random shooting, then why do you think these witnesses that you have or whatever it is are afraid to come forward?
Yeah, why are they backing off?
Well, it random shooting in the sense that it was random between the victim and the shooters. These shooters are well known within their community, and that's where most of the witnesses came from.
And
these
they're
guys,
frightened.
These guys have a reputation, and the witnesses are frightened. The other witnesses, again, the ones that I'm hoping come forward, they don't know these guys, but they're well aware of what they did, and obviously they're afraid for themselves and their families.
Did it drive you nuts, Lois, to drive around your city knowing that the person who killed your daughter might be right there?
No, I haven't thought of it in that manner. It drives me nuts not to have a closure. We want Kate to be able to move on and be at peace, and we want to be at peace, and without some kind of closure, that's not going to happen.
Albuquerque, hello.
Hello. I am calling to find out why you all have been on the air for 10 minutes and never once mentioned the drug connections or where the FBI has not responded to any correspondence that's been sent them.
Drug connection, what do you mean?
There is a possibility of a drug connection with the Vietnamese, but it certainly is not proven, and that's why I didn't mention it. We were talking about things here that have been backed
you know
up,
to be fact.
That we
was
know about.
Was the FBI
about.
Brought in on this at all?
No, not that I know of. Again, another leaf in the wind, and the FBI winds have to be very calm.
From what I've been told, the FBI did want to enter the case and the police did not want them to. If they had, it would have been very good, I think, because they're in a position to explore what's going on across state lines, and our local police were not.
We'll be back with our remaining moments with Lois Duncan and Robert Schwartz. Patty Duke tomorrow night. This is Larry King Live. Don't go away. Time for another call. Fayetteville, North Carolina, for Lois Duncan and Robert Schwartz. Hello.
Good evening, sir. I would like to ask you, Ms. Duncan, first, my deepest condolences. Did you find it therapeutic to write the book, and do you feel re-victimized by some of the questions that are being posed to you tonight?
I didn't write the book for therapy. I wrote the book because I wanted to keep total track of what was happening throughout this whole thing. And so it was not difficult to write it. It was keeping me sane to write it, but it wasn't particularly therapeutic.
And do any of the calls bother you?
No, none of the calls bother me, and none of the questions bother me. I think they need to be asked, and they need to be answered.
Going to solve this, you think, Bob?
We'll see if this show helps.
Thank you both very much.
Thank you for having us.
Lois Duncan, the book, Who Killed My Daughter, from Delacorte, and Robert Schwartz. He is the district attorney in Albuquerque. We thank you for joining us. We'll be with you in 1 hour, The Larry King Show on Mutual Radio with Robert.